1999 मई का महीना, हमारा भारत देश एक बहुत बड़े संकट से गुजरने वाला था और वो है कारगिल युद्ध। कारगिल युद्ध जिसे ऑपरेशन विजय के नाम से भी जाना जाता है, भारत और पाकिस्तान के बीच मई और जुलाई 1999 कश्मीर के कारगिल जिले में हुए सशस्त्र संघर्ष का नाम है। पाकिस्तान की सेना और कश्मीरी उग्रवादियों ने भारत और पाकिस्तान के बीच की नियंत्रण रेखा पार करके भारत की जमीन पर कब्जा करने की कोशिश की। हमारे जैसा देश जो हर दिशा से खतरों से घिरा हुआ है, जो हर दिन भारी घुसपैठ का सामना करता है, जिसमें पाकिस्तान जैसे अनैतिक पड़ोसी देश है जो संघर्ष विराम का उल्लंघन करते हैं, इन सशस्त्र बलों के बिना हमारे अस्तित्व की कल्पना करना असंभव है। हमारा मिशन वॉन्डरर्स फ्लाइग्रेड की शुरुआत थैंक यू इंडियन आर्म्ड फोर्सेस इसी विचार से शुरू हुई है और हम सभी से अनुरोध करते हैं कि हम आज के खतरों के बारे में बात करें, उन सैनिकों की बात करें जो ढाल बनकर इन खतरों से निपट रहे हैं, उनके बलिदानों के बारे में बात करें, शहीदों के बारे में बात करें तथा उनके परिवारों के बारे में बात करें कि वे इन विषम परिस्थितियों का सामना करते हैं। अंत में मैं उन सभी दर्शकों से विनम्र आग्रह करूंगा कि सदैव भारतीय सशस्त्र बलों को धन्यवाद दे। जय हिंद।
सो हियर वी आर विद द फ्लैगराइट टीम व्हिच रोड फ्रॉम हैदराबाद टू कारगिल। लेट्स हियर मोर फ्रॉम देम।
हेलो ऑल, Flagrid, we have started this in the year 2016. So we have done three phases so far, and this is an idea that myself and Praveen, हम जैसे बैठ के एक दिन बात कर रहे थे, जैसे हमने देखा कि थोड़े बहुत नौजवान बहुत बड़े कॉलेज से, we don't want to take the names, ऐसे एंटी नेशनलिस्ट के स्लोगन लगा रहे थे।
Slogans being raised at Jawaharlal Nehru University earlier this week against India on the anniversary marking Afzal Guru's hanging.
क्या आप इसलिए टैक्स देते हैं कि आपके पैसे से चलने वाली एक सरकारी यूनिवर्सिटी में आप ही के देश की बर्बादी की कस्में खाई जाएं और भारत के खिलाफ नारे लगाए जाएं? ये एक ऐसी खबर है जिसे देखकर आज देश के लिए अपनी जान दांव पर लगाने वाले जवानों को भी गुस्सा आ जाएगा और आज उन जवानों का दिल टूट जाएगा।
हमने सोचा कि ये सही नहीं है। We wanted to, कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट आर एफर्ट, जो भी है बस बातों से नहीं कुछ करेंगे, सुनचे बस उसके हिसाब से हम फ्लैगरेड ने बस शुरू करें। बाय गॉड्स ग्रेस वी गॉट गुड सपोर्ट।
डे वन ऑन 14th जुलाई 2018 द फ्लैगरेड टीम हैव गैदर्ड एट गांधीनगर। Since the flag ride's inception, it has become a customary to start the ride from Karthik Kokala's place. We have once again double-checked our saddlebags, tightened them, and headed towards the flag-off venue. Team has prayed the Almighty to shower blessings on us and give us strength to reach the Kargil War Memorial for the Vijay Diwas in monsoon. We have started our ride from the fourth tallest Indian flagpole, which is in Sanjeevaya Park. We really thank the Buddha Purnima project officers for accepting our request of carrying out flag off event inside the Sanjeevaya Park, right next to the flagpole. We would like to thank the media for covering our story despite the drizzle.
Pakistan ko, Bharat deshaniki madhyana jariginatvanti కార్గిల్ యుద్ధం ఉందో, అనేక మంది సైనికులు ప్రాణత్యాగం చేసి భారత భూభాగాన్ని రక్షించడంలో అమరులయ్యారు. కార్గిల్ యుద్ధంలో పాకిస్తాన్ను మట్టి కరిపించడం జరిగింది. దేశమంతా కూడా ఈ జులై 26వ తేదీని కార్గిల్లో సాధించినటువంటి విజయానికి ప్రతీకగా విజయ దివస్ గా మనమందరం నిర్వహిస్తూ ఉంటాము.
ఇంకా బాగా అన్ని విధాలుగా ప్రపంచంలో అన్ని విధాలు కూడా మొదలుగామ దేశంగా ఉండే అవకాశం ఉంది.
The flag off for our adventurous ride to Kargil Vijay Diwas was given by Honorable Member of Parliament Sri Kishan Reddy Garu and Honorable Former Minister Sri Bandar Dattatreya Garu, Honorable Congress Leader Sri Anand Gowd Garu, Wanderers India Head Mr. Lalit Jain, our Wanderers brothers and sisters and our family and friends. The flag off was given around 11 a.m. and the flag ride team headed towards Nagpur Highway. We have reached Nirmal around 5 p.m. after 250 kilometers of riding for 6 hours. We have checked into Singh's King Dhaba for the accommodation. Day 2. On 15th July, we have resumed our ride from Nirmal and headed towards Nagpur. The total distance to cover was around 300 kilometers. And we have reached Nagpur around 6 p.m. Thanks to our brothers Sachin Dada and team of Unido Club. They have welcomed us in a grand way. In Nagpur, we had great experience interacting with the members of Unido Club over dinner. Day 3. On 16th July, we have continued our journey. Our initial destination as per the plan was to reach Jhansi by dusk. However, due to the intermittent rains, we had to adjust our speeds and be more cautious, keeping safety of the complete pack in mind. This was one of the toughest and dangerous stretches we rode. All the way it was raining, but suddenly the rain turned into intense storm with heavy winds. The winds turned much stronger within no time and started pushing each of us towards the left side of the highway into roadside ditches. Our team had to exercise extreme caution. And this is exactly where the teamwork comes into picture. We take care of each other in a way to ensure we are all together safe and sound. Finally, with a great struggle, we have reached Lalitpur and checked into Hotel Lalit Palace. The worst part is, none of us are left with any dry clothes to wear. And this is what we call an adventure. Day 4. On 17th July, after the breakfast at Lalitpur, we have started our ride towards Agra. And we have made it to Agra comfortably. In Agra, we were welcomed by Rider Shivam of Royal Riders Club, who has booked our accommodation in advance and has helped us get settled. A big thanks to Shivam.
What about the early phases out of the six of you, who were the first two, three people, those who were there in the first three phases? Can we get something on the first three phases as well?
Hi guys. Andarki salaam alaikum. Namaste. Actually, ये क्या है, हम जब ये फ्लैग राइड करना चाह रहे थे स्टार्टिंग एज पवन सेट, पवन बोले थे, हम लोग ऐसे ही बैठ के चिट चाट कर रहे थे, टीवी देख रहे थे, ऐसे न्यूज़ में देवर सम स्लोगन्स हुए चल रहे थे, जैसा पवन बोले थे, फिर हम दिल को दुख हुआ, अरे यार इंडियन आर्मी इतना कर रही है, इंडियन आर्मी बॉर्डर पर रह रही है, बॉर्डर सिक्योरिटी फोर्स उधर है, पूरा कारगिल में इंडियन आर्मी है, इतना उन लोग पूरा फैमिली को छोड़ के, ही मिसेस सम प्रीशियस मोमेंट्स और समथिंग इन हिज लाइफ, बट वो उधर रह के जो सेवा अपने के लिए कर रहा है, ये लोग उनको बोल रहे हैं, दैट इज़ रॉन्ग, वी फेल्ट वेरी बैड. सो हम सोचे वी शुड थैंक इंडियन आर्मी फोर्स, वी शुड टेक दिस, ये जो है अपन ये थोड़ा बहुत अपने से जितना होता है उतना ये स्लोगन थैंक यू इंडियन आर्मी फोर्सेस, ये अपन पहुंचना है, हर एक सिटीजन को पहुंचना है जितना हो सके उतना, मे बी इट मे बी 5% पीपल और 10% पीपल, वो जाना बोल के हम लोग ये स्टार्ट करें. जब ये स्टार्ट करें हम लोग दो ही थे व्हेन वी आर थिंकिंग, ये स्टार्ट हुए बाद हम लोग अल्लू ऐसे डिस्कशन करे तो और एक हमारा काप है अभिषेक, वो भी बोला मैं भी आता हूँ, लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस इज अ गुड थिंग वी आर डूइंग. जब स्टार्टिंग हम जो ये स्टार्ट करे छोटा दिल से, चलो शुरू करेंगे बोल के स्टार्ट करें, वी हैड सक्सेस इन फेज वन वी हैड ए सर्क्यूट, लाइक वी हैव कवर्ड, हम तीन फॉर्मल आर्म फोर्सेस जो है वो पूरा कवर करें, वी फ्रॉम हैदराबाद वी स्टार्टेड, वी वेंट टू विशाखापट्टनम where naval defense is there, from there we went to Gopalpur Air Force Academy, from there we went to Nagpur Regimental, from there Hyderabad, we had this subject. As a start of our journey, teen genesis start of second phase, we had total 5-6 members, third phase we had 9 members, fourth phase we are 12, fifth phase we don't know, jidhar bhi ja sakta hai.
Day 5. The next morning, rider Himanshu from Agra Enfielders Club has taken us to a popular food joint of Agra. We have experienced some local delicacies. We have tasted the famous thick lassi of Agra. And yes, it was yummy. Thanks to Himanshu of Agra Enfielders. Thanking the Agra people and monuments, we have headed towards New Delhi. This stretch between Agra and Delhi is again one of the most sought after stretches for many riders and drivers. This is because of the Yamuna Express. What we have felt is, it is not a road but a runway. Finally, first time ever in our lives, we have paid toll for our bullets. Yes, this expressway charges for two-wheelers as well. We have reached New Delhi around 4 p.m. We have checked into an after story. We really loved it.
What about support from your club? How did that pan out?
We 12 members are part of Wanderers Club in Hyderabad, and we have about more than 4,000 plus followers in the club who are very 400 plus active riders. So during the periodic rides that happens in the club, so we got meet each other and became friends. And then flag ride 4. People who have similar passion, similar thoughts, we came together and started the ride. That's how we 12 started this journey.
So thanks, Raj. Like Raj explained, Flag Ride team, it is nothing but a bunch of like-minded people who were extracted from the same Wanderers Club. Right? So we are all part of a Wanderers Club. That's the fundamental thing. तो उसमें ऐसा है कि हम जब ये शुरू करें फ्लैग राइड वन, तो मैं प्रवीण और अभिषेक कौरला जब हम शुरू करें, उसके बाद में हम टू करें, टू में कार्तिक का, तो वैसे ही सारे क्लब में सबको मालूम हुआ कि हम क्या कर रहे थे, हमारा ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है, क्या क्या डिसीशंस ले रहे हैं, कैसे कैसे परमिशंस लेकर. सिमिलरली एवरीबडी एल्स वर ऑल्सो इंटरेस्टेड. तो हम क्या करें, जो इंटरेस्टेड थे, जो हमको पहले जो अप्रोच हुए saying that अगर आपका जब next flag raid होगा तो please we want to be part of that, right? So we felt very honored. Obviously we felt very glad that people would like to join our ride. So वैसे ही अब ये जो team बना, we were all people who have been asking us कि कब होगा next flag raid, and now they are the core flag raid members.
It's time for our bikes to see the doctor. We have visited a nearby Royal Enfield Service Center and got our bike's health check done. Couple of our bikes were diagnosed with serious problems and the RE Service Center have immediately rectified the problems which otherwise could have led to a breakdown and might have an impact on the rest of our journey. By evening, all of our bikes were back in roaring condition. We Wanderers have a new daily chapter, which is led by rider Rachit Malik. We had a connect session with Rachit and a couple of other riders like Rohit Mishra, Abhishek Padmakar and Naren Sharma. This session has actually helped us get rid of the ambiguity in our minds. Day 6. We have resumed our journey and headed towards Kurukshetra. En route, we have decided to check into Amrik Sukhdev for the yummy parathas. We have headed to Kurukshetra and have reached Gita Dham Ashram in Kurukshetra. This ashram is being maintained by rider Somansh Chawla and his family. We really thank Somansh Chawla for the wonderful hospitality, and we were lucky to have spent a night in such a peaceful ashram.
What about finances? So that's a critical part of any journey. 22 days is not an easy thing to plan. So how did you manage your finances?
खर्चा तो बहुत ज़्यादा ही आता. Travel कर रहे हैं, आपका accommodation, आपका food, आपके गाड़ी का maintenance, petrol, बहुत बहुत कुछ. तो by God's grace हम we were able to save little amounts. As on today, everything, all these four phases were all self-funded. So आए थे थोड़े थोड़े जने आए आके they wanted us to do some branding and marketing and they wanted to sponsor. मगर since our main motto and the objective of this entire ride is a lot to do with patriotism about our armed forces. तो हम वो commercial element नहीं लाना चाहते थे. तो फॉर वन ऑफ दोज रीजन्स वी हैव केप्ट इट अ वेरी मॉडेस्ट थिंग. हम अपने से जितना होता, मगर इट्स ऑल सेल्फ फंडेड.
वी हैवंट कॉम्प्रोमाइज ऑन स्पेंडिंग ऑन पेट्रोल वाइल हाउएवर यस वी हैव कॉम्प्रोमाइज. बजट इज अ कंस्ट्रेंट फॉर एवरीबडी. एज पवर्स राइटली मेंशन, वी हैव सेल्फ फंडेड, वी हैव टू सेव एंड देन स्पेंड ऑन दिस. सो वी हैव कॉम्प्रोमाइज ऑन आवर स्टे अकोमोडेशंस. वी डिडंट स्पेंड ऑन लाविश hotels to stay, at the lowest decent hotels we could afford. We stayed in those hotels and we didn't spend much on the food. But yes, those money where we saved in the hotels and the food, we spent on the petrol. Because we wanted to ride longer distances. That was the objective.
Day 7. We have started our journey to Manali from Gita Dham. En route near Chandigarh, we have met a rider Geetika, who is a solo rider from Chandigarh.
అట్లా ఏ గురి ఆడు ఇంకా టర్నింగ్స్ ఉంటాయి, ఆ టర్నింగ్ ఒక్క టర్నింగ్ మిస్ అయినా కూడా మళ్ళీ ఉరకాలి ఉరకాలి ఏం.
After Chandigarh, it was end of riding on planes. We literally mean it. From there on, there were no planes to ride. It's just twists, turns, ups and downs. We had a great time riding into the hills. Maneuvering in the guard roads of Mandi was something we shall never forget. Late that evening, we were almost reaching Manali, and it rained. With drenched jackets, water everywhere in our saddlebags, with wet shoes and softened palms and feet, we have checked into Krishnam Palace, Manali.
The planning of the ride is also very critical. So how did you guys come up with the plan? Was it the shortest way to reach there, or was it the easiest way to reach there, or as mentioned earlier, was it the best possible way where we could enjoy the ride? How did you plan that particular part?
We have started with multiple sessions of our schedule. Okay, so schedule kaisa karenge, kab shuru honge. So ideally the biggest challenge for us is we have to be there in Kargil for Vijay Diwas on 26th of July. Agar hum Delhi se Manali hote hue jayenge, to when will we be reaching Kargil? अगर हम दिल्ली से चंडीगढ़ से श्रीनगर होते हुए जाएंगे तो हम कब रीच होंगे? तो ये पूरा प्लानिंग पूरा करना पड़ा. एंड फॉर्चुनेटली वी इन आर क्लब एंड इन यू नो इन नेबरिंग क्लब्स वी हैव गुड बंच ऑफ पीपल हु हैव बीन डूइंग ऑल दिस लद्दाख स्पिटी राइड्स. तो हमको बहुत सपोर्ट मिला उन लोगों से. वो बहुत सारे यू नो दे हैव गाइडेड अस कि आप ये रूट लेना, आप यहाँ पे स्टे करो, ये एंड दिस मे नंबर ऑफ डेज इट मे टेक अप्रॉक्सीमेटली, एंड दिस इज़ द बेस्ट रोड, ये रोड अच्छा है, ये रोड अच्छा नहीं. तो इट्स अ वेरी कलेक्टिव एफर्ट स्केड्यूलिंग. आई वुड से इट्स अ कलेक्टिव एफर्ट. सारा सबके थॉट प्रोसेस उसमें है. एंड फाइनली वी केम अप विद द कंप्लीट रूट मैप. हम बफर में एवरी 1000 किलोमीटर्स को 2 days बफर में रखे गए. अगर इन द इवेंट ऑफ एनी अगर गाड़ी को कुछ हो गया या कुछ प्रॉब्लम, वेदर इज़ नॉट रियली सपोर्टिव, तो हमको अगर कहीं पे रुकना पड़ा एक्स्ट्रा 1 more day, सो वी डोंट टेक दैट प्रेशर ऑफ रीचिंग द नेक्स्ट डेस्टिनेशन ऑन टाइम. तो वैसा स्केड्यूलिंग चल.
Day 8, वी वर ऑल गेयरिंग अप फॉर द रियल टफ राइड टुवर्ड्स रोहतांग पास. The previous night, as we rode to the hotel late in heavy rain, we haven't realized the beauty of Manali until we came out of the room and witnessed the mesmerizing beauty. We were astonished. We were connected to an adventure tour operator, Jigme Singhe by Rohit Mishra, to help us complete the permit formalities and other logistics. Jigme helped us with extra fuel cans that we shall be carrying as there are hardly any petrol bunks, and he has also helped us with guidance to take permits. Finally, around 10 a.m. we have started our journey towards Rohtang Pass, crossing all the checkpoints successfully. Riding through the mountains, I'm falling short of words to explain the beauty of these mountains. As if someone has painted. As if we were riding into the clouds. The fresh cold breeze and the mist that we were experiencing as we ride was amazing. We felt blessed to ride in these terrains on our bikes. The first target of riding to one of the many highest peaks is achieved. We were at Rohtang Pass thanks to everyone for the support and great teamwork by 11 of us. After spending some time at the Rohtang Pass, we have headed towards Jispa via Keelong. I may have to talk a bit more about this route. As many must be aware that these roads that maneuver into one of the world's toughest terrains are being maintained by the Indian Army Border Roads Organization, or BRO in short. In one statement, tougher roads need toughest technical and disciplined teams to maintain. And a big thanks to BRO for enabling thousands of riders and tourists like us to experience the beauties of Ladakh region. Starting from this place, the upcoming places like Jispa, Pang, Leh, Khardungla, Batalik, Dras, Zojila have lots of water crossings. Rough and slippery roads with gravel. Broken tarmac with no guard railings alongside of these highways. This is due to the drastic climatic changes of the mountains. Heavy rains and landslides make it highly challenging for the authorities to keep up the road conditions. Yet, BRO plays a key role in ensuring free traffic movement and helps commuters to have safer rides to their respective destinations. Riders are highly prone to accidents on these roads. Many have slipped into the valley and had fatal injuries. It is recommended to exercise extra caution while riding on these roads. Godspeed. Finally, after crossing the beautiful roads of Keelong amidst of the Himalayan mountains, we have reached our destination, Jispa. When someone living in urban chaos thinks of a place to rejuvenate, the immediate picture that flashes in mind is beautiful mountains, fresh water river, pebble banks, tents, bonfire, yummy food, and absolute silence. This is exactly what we have checked into. Nomadic camps of Jispa. We would also like to thank Royal Enfield for setting up a 24/7 assistance facilities in many places of Ladakh region. This is to support the riders visiting Leh during the season. I got my front brake lever replaced that was damaged at Rohtang Pass.
Apart from the club, family also plays an important part. How did they support?
When we, you know, say to our family that we are going out for 20 days and that too for, you know, on these terrains, obviously I'm sure every family will be, you know, surprised for a second, and they will obviously try to convince us not to go. But then I think it lies, as Raj was mentioning, you know, it lies in the point that, you know, we have to convince them, we have to ensure that they understand what exactly we are doing and what we are loving. And then I think again our families want to say thanks to the armed forces on martyrs. So that's where we were all able to convince our families. And then in the end, when we come back, right, we see that, you know, they're very happy that we are doing the same, I mean, doing exactly what we conveyed. So I would say, you know, to start with, the what three phases has done and the what I have done in fourth phase, a great thing, you know, it was a great experience.
Day 9. The next morning, we have geared up to ride towards Leh. And a landslide once again. Tourists waiting there have welcomed us dancing for the landslides. Aur hum to Hyderabadi hain,
और हमारा मस्ती भी शुरू हो गया. द लैंडस्लाइड वॉज क्लियर्ड इन नो टाइम एंड वी हैव रिज्यूम्ड आवर राइड वंस अगेन. We have experienced some exciting yet dangerous water crossings. We were in fact prepared for the water crossings as cautioned by our advisors. We wore knee-length gumboots so that our feet don't get wet, as the temperatures are low and can fall much below by evenings. It is important to keep ourselves warm and avoid any contact with cold water. Especially shoes, socks, trousers, etc. should not get wet. As we have made progress towards Leh, the patches of rough roads have significantly increased, and we had to fasten the bungee cord of our saddle bags once again. Due to heavy rains and upstream water that was flowing into the canals, the roads were literally filled with water, and it added more to the adventure. Despite these challenges, we have braved to achieve another highest peak of this ride, which is Nakila Pass. This pass is at altitude of 15,547 feet. This is roughly around 4.7 kilometers above the sea level. After this adventure, we had to pull over at Pang. We have checked into a homestay at Pang. It took us around 8 hours to cover 163 kilometers. This was one of the slowest days because of the AMS and tough terrains.
This was a long journey, so 22 days away from your house. So any sicknesses, any...
सिकनेस बोल तो होम सिकनेस तो नहीं है, मगर एक्यूट माउंटेन सिकनेस बोल के एक हुआ, वो तो हमारा मिस्टेक था जो हुआ, मगर किसको हुआ वो क्या है वही बात करके आपको बताएंगे.
दैट्स द प्लान. वी रीच डाउन टू जस्पा. यू नो आई कैन सी व्हाट इज गोइंग ऑन बट आई कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज गोइंग. सो इट्स So, I was in a trance, complete trance. I cannot, people are talking, people are cheering me up. You can do it, you can, they were encouraging me rather. I was struck by acute mountain sickness so badly that, you know, I could not, you know, my mind was blank, completely blank. They say that there is a black hole, right? So that is what my situation was. So, we reached down to a place, over there we settled down. I had hot water and that settled me down, and since then I've been taking the water so that it suffices my AMS. So that is how I felt during this complete ride.
Day 10. The next morning we have resumed our ride from Pang to experience the beautiful plains in Ladakh called Moray Plains. It was a relief for the team to ride on these plains after hundreds of miles maneuvering between mountains. After experiencing the acute mountain sickness, riding through the water crossings, riding through the tough terrains, we have further realized the struggle one has to go through to be part of this land.
We really thank our armed forces for their unconditional sacrifices. We salute them for their zeal to continue guarding the nation despite all these extreme climatic conditions and tough terrains. Thank you, sir. After a photo session at the Moray Plain, we have headed towards Taglangla, which is at 5.3 kilometers above the sea level. Taglangla peak achieved. Finally, we have reached Leh City around 5 pm after riding for 170 kilometers. We have checked into Magsum guest house. Day 11. So on day 1 in Leh, we have visited the Pangong Lake, which is around 150 kilometers from Leh. Pangong Lake is one of the most beautiful lakes of Ladakh region. On day 2 of Leh, we rode to mighty Kardungla. Kardungla, which is one of the most wished destination to be for every rider. It is because Kardungla is located at an altitude of 5.3 kilometers above the sea level, and it is the highest motorable road in the world. Though majority of the portion is now tarmac, the mountain peak points roads are still rugged. They feel raw and rugged because of the landslides, which are very frequent. We have witnessed fellow riders who were on the same expedition skidding many a times. It feels horrifying to see the damaged roads, big potholes, boulders, mud and slush. Reaching Kardungla is inarguably one of the toughest challenges. We were super excited to achieve this marvelous peak, Kardungla. On the same evening of 25th July, we have started our ride to Kargil for the big day from Leh. Since the Vijay Diwas is on 26th July, which is the immediate next day, we really had to reach Kargil at least by late night or Lamayaru by midnight. Situations suddenly turned against us. By the time we have reached Khalsi, we were stopped at Khalsi checkpost as the road to Kargil was closed due to heavy rains and landslides. We had to take shelter in the checkpost. Thanks to the police personnel for helping us with the accommodation in that extreme cold weather.
The roads conditions were, I mean, initially I think the plains would have been better, but how was the road conditions once you crossed into Kashmir? What is your guidance for people, those who are planning to go?
Normally, we believe that long distance riding resembles life in more ways than one. So the destination is far away. You can't reach it in an instant. You can't go neither too slow nor too fast. You have to maintain a moderate speed. And it's not entirely about the speed with which we travel. We ought to have that patience to do any long distance ride. And the roads also, you get to encounter all types of roads in a ride like this. 4-lane highways, 2-lane, metal roads, concrete roads, no roads, ghat roads, every sort of road you can imagine. And even the climate also was very testing, right from rain to extreme cold conditions to extreme hot conditions, slippery roads, muddy roads, every kind of. So in that perspective, I think that it this kind of ride resembles life itself. So you ought to go out of that comfort zone and you ought to face that adventures, if we can call them so.
Just to add what Sagar said, when the road conditions are topic of calm, Jojula Pass is considered to be one of the most dangerous roads in the world. Across the pass, you'll have 1.5 feet to 2 feet slush mixed with stones. So, and it's a very narrow road. One side you have a hill, the other side on the left side where we ride, it's a valley. Right? It's a very narrow road. So, you trucks keep coming from the other side, you know, you'll have to move very closer to the valley side. You'll have hardly, you know, you'll find a place to keep your foot down and then the slush, and then you need to pass it on. Slush is one of the, I would say, not dangerous experience, but rather actually very exciting and then great experience to ride in Jojula Pass.
I would like to add very few points. So in this one ride, we had a opportunity to experience all kinds of roads. I mean, yes, obviously all kinds of roads available in the world. Right from a small narrow one lane road till a 6-lane express highway of Yamuna Expressway between Agra and Delhi. Then the gravel roads, the tough terrains of Ladakh. And obviously in this ride, what we were expecting is those terrains, the ghat roads, and in altitude. Riding in altitude is altogether a different experience. In altitude, in those tough terrains, it was a lifetime experience. And in just one ride, we had experienced all kinds of roads. And I guess we don't have anything left now, but still.
Day 13. The morning of 26th July, we were all geared up by 6 a.m. But disappointingly, the Lamayuru road to Kargil continued to be closed. But the checkpost police have helped us with an alternative route to reach Kargil. That is via Batalik. Batalik, we will fall short of words to explain its beauty. The previous night landslides episode happened for our good. Yes, had it not been for the landslide, we wouldn't have ridden into Batalik. It is lush green with apricot gardens everywhere. Out of all the miles that we have ridden so far, this stretch from Khalsi to Kargil via Batalik will always be our favorite. We have tough road on one side, flowing river on the other side. Small villages en route depicts the culture and lifestyles of Kashmiris. We really loved Batalik. Finally, around 1 p.m., we have reached Kargil War Memorial in Dras. Quickly got fresh, wore our flag ride t-shirts, took the mementos, thank you cards, and entered into the Vijay Diwas event to felicitate the officers.
Coming to the reason which you went there, Vijay Diwas, what is your memory of the event over there? It, for sure, it would be a grand event, but how did the day pan out?
Actually, what we saw there, like बोलते ना उधर जाते कि बाल उड़ जाते हैं तो हमारे रग रग में वो एक एक जोश अरे क्या है we can see the Kargil जिधर पाकिस्तान वाले आके झंडा लगाए टाइगर हिल we can see that वो देखे हम लोग एक एक पार्ट ये देखे और उधर से हम लोग उधर जो जो वेपन्स उधर से लेके आए जो उधर बेस बनाए थे पाकिस्तान वो पूरा देखे बाद गन्स देखे उधर का झंडा देखे पाकिस्तान का झंडा उल्टा लगा दिए लोगों का गन्स लगा दिए फोटोज लगाए कैसा लड़े उसका स्टोरी सुन वी हैव सीन एवरीथिंग सब देख के बाहर आए हम लोग लाइक लाइक अरे इतना करे इंडियन आर्मी, थोड़ा ऐसा बाजू का है आते कि एक ही जगह एक 500 to 600 इंडियन आर्मी जवान्स रहें तो इंडिया के लिए वार में मरे पूरों का लाइक इट्स लाइक ग्रेव के जैसा पूरा लग। एक्चुअली वो देखते कि अभी आंखों में पानी बस नहीं निकल रहा, मगर वो दिख इतने जने और जोश में, अरे दिस इज इंडियन आर्मी यार, इतने जने अपन इधर बैठ के एंजॉय कर रहे हैं, मूवी देख रहे हैं शाहरुख खान का, चिरंजीवी का, और अपना एंजॉयमेंट अपन कर रहे हैं। वी ऑल आर गेटिंग दिस ड्यू टू देम। इवन इंडियन इकोनॉमी इज ग्रोइंग अच्छा है, जिधर अपना आर्मड फोर्सेस जो अपने देश को रक्षा कर रहे हैं, तो अपन को इधर फ्रूट्स अपन खा रहे हैं। एनीथिंग, देश का अगर देश सेफ है तो वी गेट इन्वेस्टर्स। देश साफ ने अभी पाकिस्तान में जाके कोई क्यों लगाओ बोलो कोई नहीं ला, इंडिया लाइक इट इज़ सेफ, लाइक दैट्स वाई आई फील इंडियन आर्मी इज़ ग्रेट। वी हैव टू फील ग्रेट, वी शुड सेल्यूट देम, थैंक देम।
तो बस जस्ट आई मीन माय कंक्लूजन विल बी ये थैंकिंग द इंडियन आर्म्ड फोर्सेस शुड बी अवर डेली रूटीन इफ यू आस्क मी। कि अगर आप जब भी एक सोल्जर को देखे, ठीक है, यू प्लीज थैंक देम, ओके, आप वेयर अ स्माइल, ठीक है, आप जस्ट हैव दैट इन योर हार्ट सेइंग दैट जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ देयर अनकंडीशनल सैक्रिफाइसेस टुडे वॉट एवर you know happiness that we are you know enjoying oh, just because of them. Itna threat hai apne country ko from left side of the country, from right side of the country, China se, Pakistan se, na jane kya kya. So you know all these soldiers wo both bravery you know itne saal se, and this institution is not something new, itne saal se wo they have inculcated this culture, and let's all wear that pride, and we must be thankful to the armed forces, and I am really looking forward for more such people to come together and then you know support this cause. That's it.
We interacted with many soldiers, many armed forces guys, and there was one of the instance where I had to speak with one of the armed forces guy, and I was explaining him that yeah, we came all the way from Hyderabad just to thank you, and it is a wonderful experience, and we feel pleasure to meet you guys. And he was in return thanking me, stating aap itna dur aaye hame thank karne ke liye, hum bolne chahiye aapko thank you bol. So he was telling hum aise desh mein hain jahan pe hum hamare upar stones built karte hain, aur itna dur wo stage ko aap aake thank you bolna hame garv ho raha hai hame. I felt I'm feeling happy bolke he hugged me, and it was so emotional feeling that you know I can feel that even now. This flag ride is actually about emotions and the patriotism that you wear, and I have to thank Indian Armed Forces once again. Jai Hind.
Day 14 Zojila Pass. This name terrifies us. It was an insane terrain. Due to heavy rains, the pass has turned into a death trap. The pass was very narrow and slippery. We could barely find space to overtake a vehicle or move left, give space for the opposite vehicles coming towards us. After a tiring 15 days of continuous ride, Zojila Pass had actually thrown a fierce challenge on our face. Couple of riders have skidded and fell. Adding to the challenges, it was a cloudy day and visibility was barely for 20 feet.
Due to the moving clouds onto us, we have started losing the vision of our co-rider. Any miscalculation can lead us to, I better don't say it out. After struggling for almost 2 hours, we have finally completed Jojila Pass and reached Sonmarg Road. Finally, we have checked into Silver Star Hotel in Srinagar. We rode around 150 kilometers for 9 hours on that day.
One question, I mean, I was waiting for to coming to that particular part of the section. So, the motive was to reach Kargil, was to be there with the army, right? So, support them in all that. Were there any problems or any situations when you got there, right? So, it's an ever-changing political scenario. Did you find any issues over there? Or was it an easy thing?
I'm sure the entire team, everybody wants to definitely share their experience on this. So to begin with, I would just like to say, it is so unfortunate. It is so unfortunate for us that we were literally, I would not say threatened, but we were asked to be extremely cautious just because we were carrying the Indian flag. Right. It is, after all, it is our nation, it is our country, and we wear that pride of carrying the flag, and I deserve the right to do so, wherever I like in my country. But the situations there are so fragile ki agar hum India flag leke ja rahe, hamare army officers se leke everybody were concerned. तो ऐसे ही हम श्रीनगर में, the moment we were just about to enter Srinagar, you have a bypass wherein you can skip Srinagar and then start getting into the Jammu highway, और एक श्रीनगर के अंदर से जाना पड़ेगा. तो we were stopped at the bypass by Jammu police because 11 bikes which are completely saddled up and we are all geared up with complete, we are all fully geared up and बड़े बड़े flags है, Indian flags. वहाँ पे इंडिया फ्लैग लेके जाना मतलब है कुछ अलग ही मतलब है वहाँ पे, एंड वी डिड नॉट, वी हैव नॉट एक्सपीरियंस्ड इट सो फार. यस वी हैव लर्नड इट एंड वी हैव हर्ड इन न्यूज़, पर बहुत बार देखे और खुद कभी एक्सपीरियंस नहीं करे. इतना सेंसिटिव एरियाज है वहाँ पे. हम जैसे जम्मू पुलिस ने पूछा कि आप कहाँ जा रहे हैं, हमने बोला कि यस हम वी आर हेडिंग टूवर्ड्स जम्मू. तो हम वी वॉन्टेड टू टेक द हाईवे बाईपास तो हम श्रीनगर स्किप कर सकें और हम जल्दी पहुंच जाए जम्मू हाईवे पे. तो बोला कि नहीं आप ये रूट नहीं ले सकते, विच इज़ नॉट सेफ. जम्मू पुलिस ने बोला कि ये सेफ नहीं है, यू रादर टेक द सिटी का रोड. उन्होंने बोला कि भाई साहब अब 11 बाइक्स है, सिटी का रोड लेंगे तो इट विल बी वेरी, इट विल बी डार्क फॉर अस बाई द टाइम वी रीच द नेक्स्ट डेस्टिनेशन. तो नहीं होगा. बोले कि सर आप नहीं जा सकते, इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू टू गो. उन्होंने बोला क्यों, स्टोन पेल्टर्स. बोला कि ये क्या चीज़ है, अगर आप फ्लैग लेके जा रहे हैं स्टोन बिल्डर्स एंड दे विल डेफिनेटली स्टार्ट थ्रोइंग स्टोन्स एट यू, देर कुड बी सम अनफॉर्चुनेट थिंग दैट मे हैपन एंड वी विल बी हेल्ड रिस्पॉन्सिबल. हम ये नहीं काम हम नहीं कर सकते, हम नहीं छोड़ सकते आप. मैं फिर से आई हैव इंसिस्टेड नो, मगर ये टाइम पे क्या होगा. देन ही रिमाइंडेड मी, सर आज तो फ्राइडे आप भूल गए ना कि भाई अच्छा है ओके फाइन. नाउ इतना सुनने के बाद आई सेड, आई मीन आई दिस मैसेज दैट आई गॉट फ्रॉम जम्मू पुलिस, I did not, announce it through the walkie-talkie to Praveen. कि बोले तो अगर मैं करूँगा, this is kind of a panic situation. ठीक है, I did not want that to happen. So we have headed towards Srinagar into the city. जैसे हम city में enter हुए, साला everybody started looking at, they were staring at us. क्या है, क्या चल रहा है? Everybody, they had this misconception of we belong to armed forces. तो ये पूरे झंडे गंडे देख के, अरे कहाँ है, क्या है, क्या की चल रहा है यहाँ पे. तो फॉर्चुनेट एंड आई वाज वेरी वेरी कॉशियस. और प्रवीण तो बेचारा टेल में है, अगर उसको कुछ हो गया मेरे को मालूम ही नहीं पड़ता. सो ही वाज फ्रीक्वेंटली ट्राइंग टू बी इन टच विथ मी थ्रू वॉकी टॉकी. कुछ ऐसे ही बात कर रहे थे सो दैट नो वी आर इन कॉन्स्टेंट टच विथ ईच अदर. तो आई वाज ट्राइंग टू फाइंड अ वे कि हम सेफली जम्मू हाईवे का जो स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट है वहाँ तक कैसा पहुँचे वाया द सिटी. तो आई कैन सी माई मैप, आई मीन माई मोबाइल माउंट है मेरे हैंडल बार पे, आई कैन सी द मैप. ये रास्ता लेने का है, मगर वो रास्ते इतने नैरो हैं एंड यू नेवर नो कौन आके कौन अटैक करेंगे. तो फॉर्चुनेटली एक कॉम्पाउंड में से एक स्कॉर्पियो निकला बाहर, उसके पीछे कॉन्वॉय शुरू हो गया, पूरे जम्मू पुलिस शुरू हो गया. मैं सीधा मेरा पैक लेके जाके उसके पीछे लगा दिया हमारा कॉन्वॉय. देन वी स्टार्टेड यू नो वी हैव लिटरली वी रोड जस्ट बिहाइंड द कॉन्वॉय. सो पहले दे वर नॉट रियली पेइंग अटेंशन फॉर अ किलोमीटर और टू, उसके बाद में दे स्टार्टेड पेइंग अटेंशन, भाई ये लोग कौन है और ये हमारा पीछा क्यों कर रहे हैं. यू नो आई कुड सी दैट स्कॉर्पियो के पीछे एक ऐसा रेक्टेंगल में एक छोटा कट था, तो उसमें से वो जान जाके मेरे को देख रहा था. यू नो ही वॉज लुकिंग एट मी, उसका गन पूरा प्रिपेयर कर ले रहा हो क्या की है ये क्या की चल रहा, और आगे पुलिस वालों को इंटीमेट कर दिए. सो बाय गॉड्स ग्रेस वी हैव कंटिन्यूड आर राइड ऑलमोस्ट एंड ऑफ द सिटी तक. तो वहाँ पे पुलिस लोग ना डाल लेक भी क्रॉस कर दिए, हम डाल लेक भी क्रॉस कर दिए तो वहाँ पे हमको रोक दिए पुलिस लोग पकड़ लिए वहाँ पे हमको रोक दिए. बोले कि भाई तू अगर आपको जाने का है तो जाओ, मगर इसके पीछा क्यों कर रहे. हमने बोला कि सर ऐसा ऐसा सिचुएशन है एंड वी आर सो स्केर्ड. बोला कि ठीक है ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं, अभी तो हम सबको इंटीमेट कर दिए आप ऐसे आगे ठीक है. तो वी हैव कंटिन्यूड.
Major and above rank officer have come down and asked basically, you know, what is this about? Then I said, we are riding through and this is the purpose, we come to Kargil to thank Kamal forces. Then he said, it's good, but you know, you're carrying national flag on your bikes, which attracts undue attention, right? So I asked him, do you suggest to take off the flags? He said, not necessary. Okay, what we'll do is, you know, I'll convoy you in this 100 plus kilometer stretch to water distance. After that, I'll intimate the whole highway to all the officers such that, you know, nobody will stop you. In case, if you, any of you, has any problem with the localite, at every 50 meters on either side, you have our forces. Go approach them and say that I want to speak to your commander and explain to them, we'll take care. Nothing to worry. You proceed. And then for 40 kilometers, I was giving convoy. To just highlight how sensitive that highway was, you know, we traveled through Anantnag, Pahalgaon, where stone pelting happens, Pulwama, where stone pelting happens every day. Highly sensitive. And we see hundreds of army trucks passing through. And almost all the vehicles were stopped and checking as were happening. This army major, he helped us to get through that 100 plus kilometers highway without stopping anywhere. We saw people abusing, showing wrong gestures to us all through this highway, the localites. Throwing bottles, well, at that speed, you know, they filled water bottles were thrown under our bikes as you know, the bike if actually get on it in the tops and then skips. So, thanks to Indian Army, because of them actually we could safely ride that 100 plus kilometers traveling the most sensitive areas of Jammu and Kashmir. और अदर कश्मीर
एक्चुअली जम्मू पुलिस को भी हम थैंक्स करना है. हम जब कारगिल से स्टार्ट हुए श्रीनगर जा रहे हैं, एक्चुअली हमारा प्लान था श्रीनगर में नहीं रुकना. श्रीनगर पार हो गए तो अपन आगे जम्मू में सेफ है बोल के हमारे दिमाग में चल रहा था. एक्चुअली जब अपन श्रीनगर से हाईवे चढ़ते हैं उधर से एक 120 टू 150 किलोमीटर वेरी सेंसिटिव एरियाज. श्रीनगर से एंटर होने से पहले एक पुलिस ने रोका, वो हमारा अच्छा सजेशन दिया. वो सजेशन देने को हम श्रीनगर से गए अंदर सिटी में से गए हमारे को हाईवे में रोक दिए. अगर ये पुलिस जम्मू पुलिस हमारे को सजेशन नहीं देते होंगे वी वुड हैव गॉन थ्रू बाईपास रोड से गए तो हम बीच में किधर की अच्छा होता बुरा होता फंस जाते थे. लाइक अब मेरे को आइडिया नहीं है, देर आर सो मैनी डेंजरस प्लेसेस. हम वो प्लेसेस में रुकना पड़ता था रात में. अगर वो प्लेसेस में रुके तो अपने को सिक्योरिटी, हम रुकना है तो इंडियन आर्मी बेस कैंप में रुकना, वी हैव नो अदर ऑप्शंस. उधर ऑप्शन था नहीं तो हमारे को रात में नहीं मालूम होता था. लाइक वी हैड सम, वो जम्मू पुलिस ने एक काम अच्छा किया हमारे को अंदर से जाओ. और उधर गए बाद हमारे को 5 o'clock रोक दिए, हेलो जाओ विल नॉट अलाउ यू. तो हमारे को CRPF एक जवान ने हमारे को सजेशन दिया, गो एंड हैव देर इज़ ए होटल नियर बाय, देर इज़ वेरी गुड होटल, यू गो एंड स्टे देयर. तो हम रुक गए. अगर रात में वो नहीं जाने का ही अच्छा हुआ सो दैट सुबह सुबह हमारे को मेजर मिले, मेजर हमारे को कानवाई दिए we have crossed these sensitive places very safe.
I just wanted to add this one बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट है ये एड. जब ये पूरा एपिसोड हुआ, जब शाम में जब ये पूरा एपिसोड हुआ, वी वर फोर्स्ड टू गेट इन टू श्रीनगर इंस्टेड ऑफ टेकिंग द बाईपास. एंड देन वी वर स्टॉप लिटरली एंड वी वर ऑब्जेक्शन करे हम कि हम उससे आगे नहीं जाना, जम्मू हाईवे पे नहीं जाना. एंड वी वर फोर्स्ड दैट यू टेक एन अकोमोडेशन एंड यू बी हियर अंटिल मॉर्निंग, यू आर नॉट अलाउड टू गो बियॉन्ड दिस पॉइंट. ये जब पूरा हुआ तो वी नाउ अब वो प्लेस अपना नहीं है, ठीक है. एंड सो मच ऑफ थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग अराउंड यू, लॉट ऑफ प्रेशर इज देयर, एवरीबडी आर स्टेयरिंग एट यू जस्ट बिकॉज यू हैव सीन फ्लैग है अपना गाड़ी को सबको, और अपना मर्चेंडाइज पूरा इंडिया फ्लैग है, ठीक है. तो वैसा सिचुएशन था, तो हम नाइट में बात कर लिया. वी वर नॉट रियली डिसअपॉइंटेड, मगर हमको थोड़ा बुरा भी लग रहा था कि भाई ये भाई इंडिया है तो ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है यहाँ पे. ठीक है, पूरा डिनर कर लिए, सो गए, पूरा हो गया. तो सुबह उठे. नाउ सी, हम फ्लैग का एक कोड फॉलो करते, तो हम दिन में फ्लैग ओपन रहता, नाइट में जैसे ही सनसेट होता तो वी नो रोल द फ्लैग और उसको हम टाई कर देते. सो वी डोंट राइड अवर बाइक्स बाई ओपनिंग द फ्लैग ड्यूरिंग नाइट, वो हम नहीं करते. तो जैसे सुबह हुआ, इट्स टाइम फॉर अस टू ओपन द फ्लैग वहाँ पे श्रीनगर में. नाउ हेड टूवर्ड्स अनंतनाग, पहलगाम, विच आर द मोस्ट सेंसिटिव एरियाज. इतना कुछ होने के बाद सुबह डिसीजन मेकिंग का टाइम आया कि आप फ्लैग ओपन करें या नहीं करें. ठीक है, तो अब हम पूरा रेडी करें, अब कोई किससे बात नहीं कर रहा, है ना, बिकॉज वी आर ऑल इन दैट, ये हम एक ट्रॉमा में हैं, तो कोई से बात नहीं कर रहा. वी हैव ऑल स्टार्टेड आर, ऑलमोस्ट स्टार्टेड आर बाइक्स. तो नाउ हम वी हैव टू गिव द यू नो, चलो फ्लैग ऑफ करने का है वो टाइम पे जाने का. आई वॉज टॉकिंग टू प्रवीण, तो प्रवीण ने बोला मेरे को थोड़ा टाइम दे, लेट मी थिंक, बिकॉज ही इज मोर मेच्योर्ड, सो ही थिंक्स अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स, बिकॉज आई एम लिटिल अग्रेसिव इन टर्म्स ऑफ ये, ही इज मेच्योर. बोला कि थोड़ा टाइम देख, 5-10 मिनट, लेट मी थिंक अबाउट इट, कि अपन फ्लैग्स ओपन करके जाएंगे या नहीं करके जाएंगे. After 5 minutes, I was just you know holding my, I was just you know waiting for the announcement in my walkie-talkie. मैं जोर से बोला कि guys let's open the flags. So that's it. That's the moment. You know we said let everybody go to hell. This is our country. We have to ride with open flags. That's it. तो हम जैसे ही open flags करे, जय हिंद मारे, शुरू करे. And the moment we entered the highway का starting point, हंगामा हो गया वहाँ पे. You know, all the armed forces, everybody, they said, I mean, they have appreciated, no doubt about it. The same time, they are also worried कि अगर कुछ attack हो जाता इनके ऊपर क्या है. And that is what, like Raj mentioned, they have requested us or they have insisted us that we get into the convoy. That anyways, उन्हों का convoy एक जा रहा था, 100-150 गाड़ियाँ जा रहे थे, उनके बीच में हमको add कर दिए. वो videos भी हैं. तो we were lucky enough. And we feel very privileged, very honored कि हमको ऐसा treatment मिला वहाँ पे despite all these pressures. Day 16. We have headed towards the pride of all line of control events. The change of guards ceremony at Attari Wagha border. We cannot express the goosebumps experience that we have witnessed during the beating retreat ceremony. Many drove to this place to demonstrate their patriotism. Patriotism to its fullest. The screams have made us get goosebumps again and again. The beating retreat is something one must experience himself or herself, because the true feelings remain unexplainable. Day 17. The Dunda family have treated us like their relatives. We have started our journey back to home. From Amritsar, our next destination was to reach Agra. We rode for 3 days and on 20th day of our expedition, we were back in Hyderabad. We have reached Hyderabad on August 2nd. And on the same day, it happens to be Freedom Fighter
the architect of the Indian national flag, late Sri Pingali Venkaiah Garu 142nd birth anniversary.
Hi, అందరికీ నమస్కారం. సక్సెస్ఫుల్ గా విజయ్ దివాస్ కార్గిల్ యాత్ర ముగించుకొని వాండరర్స్ ఫ్లాగ్ రైడ్ టీమ్ హైదరాబాద్ చేరుతుంది. బై గాడ్ గ్రేస్ అండ్ విత్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫ్రెండ్స్ సపోర్ట్ ఐ మస్ట్ సే దట్ వీ హావ్ సక్సెస్ఫుల్లీ కంప్లీటెడ్ అవర్ రైడ్. సో నౌ బిగ్ 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 క్లాప్స్ టు ఎవ్రీవన్. థ్యాంక్స్ అ లాట్ ఫర్ దట్. యెప్, దట్స్ ఇట్.
We have called off our flag ride 4 at his statue, paying him the respect.
When a soldier attains martyrdom, his or her family receives the body in a coffin, draped with the tricolor. These departed souls are laid to rest with full military honors, and the families get pensions from the armed forces. But can any amount of money ever compensate for the loss of a loved one? The families deal with the grief in private.
Take it, Nigerian, go!
The public does not see the lonely conversations of the family of these martyrs. They do not see the pain, the suffering, the longing of a martyr's spouse in their day-to-day life. They do not see the dead eyes of a martyr's child who are forced to grow mature ahead of their age. They do not see the longing of a mortal parent to see or to talk to their son or a daughter. Yet, they wear the pride and say that my son made a supreme sacrifice for the country. My husband was a great warrior. My father was a real hero. How is this even possible? While on the other side, we have millions cursing this nation, crashing or even leaving the country in search of greener pastures. This has always puzzled us. Despite so many negative outcomes, we also see the youth of this country is still driven by the pride and sense of duty when it comes to serving the armed forces. They are the beating heart of this nation. The inception of our mission, Wanderers Flag Ride, thanking our soldiers, lies in the realization that we as a nation cannot survive and thrive without their supreme sacrifices. We are proud of our armed forces and the brave soldiers who serve in them. We salute you, O brave soldier. Jai Hind.